Good evening. This is Dave Nicolai with the University of Minnesota Extension. We're out here at the Research and Outreach Center at Rosemont, Minnesota, talking to you a little bit about temperature inversions. This is June 6th. It's in the evening. We have 76 degree temperature, and we have a low tonight of 55 degrees. However, we have 28% relative humidity and a low dew point of 44 degrees. Perfect conditions at 3 mile an hour wind all evening for temperature inversions to occur. When we have conditions that develop in the atmosphere with a lot of solar heating of the landscape, particularly on the soil surface, and then we have a rapid cooling in the evening. We have a layer of air that's trapped near the ground layer. It's warmer up above it, and the temperature inversion situation will exist. Oftentimes with application of herbicides and other pesticides, we have conditions where small droplets can easily be trapped in those particular air layers and move off target, resulting in physical drift situations. There are a number of new products coming to market for both soybean growers and corn growers in Minnesota. Some of these are growth regulator based as well as a traditional glyphosate based. All of these products do have disclaimers on their label warning about making applications during temperature inversions. Applicators are highly encouraged to read the labels carefully and follow directions and avoid temperature inversion situations when making their post-emergence applications. I'll oftentimes see low-lying fog, clouds, or a low-lying area or fog bank that looks close to the ground. That's indicative of the fact that we do have a temperature differential. There are a number of atmospheric conditions that applicators can watch for, and some of those different testing mechanisms that applicators themselves can do, such as the use of a smoke bomb or other smoke activities to see where the smoke transcends across the landscape, whether it goes vertical or whether it goes horizontal. Also be observant of dust on a gravel road that hangs in the air and does not dissipate. These are all outward signs of a situation involving a temperature inversion where a layer of air has already trapped a layer of colder air near the surface.
So in summary, conditions that favor the development of an inversion are situations when we have 25% or less cloud cover in the evening through that night, that requires light and variable winds, usually 0 to 3 miles per hour. We need to remain cautious when it's 4 to 6 miles per hour. In addition, that we need to be aware of the fact that this will actually start in mid to late afternoon. It'll intensify through the night until dawn. Then typically that inversion will dissipate into mid-morning. So be aware of 3 to 5 hours before sunset and 2 to 3 hours after sunrise.